Ugh! Oh my god.
Let me see, was it funny?
Yeah.
Where are we playing much?
No way!
How tall is that, like 9 feet?
Jennifer! Jennifer! Susan! Trip to Hawaii?
Yeah, that was clean.
That was clean.
That was super clean.
Okay, and then I can do that.
Yeah.
Super sketchy.
Brooklyn, New York.
Mexico, Maui.
So sick, bro.
Yeah.
Whoa. Okay. Whoa.
One's not felt.
It's freezing.
Nice.
Did you want it on 30?
What the heck?
Maybe I'll go. Maybe I'll go one more time.
My world entirely bears the flavor of self. As in the Wittgensteinian sense, I cannot see the eyeball, but I can see my field of vision. So too, I cannot see the metaphysical I or self, but its solipsistic projections are conspicuous. In other words, the world is the goggles I wear.
Trey Lance, there's so many of those jerseys around.
Why is he back?
I'm Rocky!
I just finished racing a polo green. Can't get any more blue than this right now.
Do you know?
If we always have our eyes fixated on what's elsewhere, the gaze of our soul is going to miss the joys that are right here. Put on the goggles of hope.
Okay.
Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. Why are professional athletes so Why are professional athletes so healthy?
Why?
Because they're full of probiotics.
Oh. Did you just make that up?
Yes.
Oh my god, that's not bad.
Okay.
Why are anteaters so healthy?
Why?
Because they're full of antibodies.
Oh.
Ooh.
14 gallons for $7.
Dang.
Not bad. Oh, nice. Okay.
The question remains, how can Ubermenschen live in harmony and unison if each respective person is having their own value structure and moral code imprinted on their own psyche? How can supermen coexist and be together in a society harmoniously? I believe it's by a unifying pneuma that is animatedly writing laws on the tablet of my heart as divorced from the divine knowledge that is stamped on the unique ethical code of my neighbor and his or her value structure, and the same goes the other way around, inverted, and vice versa. So live as a Superman, be an Ubermensch, live as a Superwoman, turn an Emersonian brazen face to the expectations of others, and utterly ignore those expectations.
Real athletes who are goats and greats, they love the pressure. They prize the pressure because they know that pressure is their opportunity to show out. It is, in sooth, a platform of performance greatness. in Greek antiquity, there was this ancient word thlipsis, which literally meant crushing beneath a weight. It meant pressure. Now, pressure is no fun, or is it? Consider the goats. Great athletes like Jordan and Brady, they prize the pressure. When the pressure is on, that's their opportunity at clutch time to show their greatness. What if we prized the pressure? Everything would be good. A Stanford neuroanatomy teacher revealed how there's a lot of data that shows the anterior mid-cingulate cortex grows in humans when they do something they don't want to do. So when you do an exercise you don't want to do, or you resist food when you're on a diet, or if you don't want to go in an ice bath but you do it anyway, it actually builds this area of your brain. The anterior mid-cingulate cortex is bigger in athletes or those who see themselves as challenged and overcome some challenge, and it maintains the same size in those who live for a very long time. But if you don't do it the next day, by the way, it shrinks. So this is not only one of the seats of willpower, but it could be the very seat of the will to live.